In life, Anne Marie cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet her with these words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my Father. May the Lord open to her the gates of paradise, that she may return to the homeland where there is no death, where eternal joy endures. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all. So good afternoon, everyone. Today we gather to honor the life of remarkable woman, Anne Marie Campbell, whose devotion to her faith and love for others touched the hearts of all who knew her. As we come together to celebrate her life, and commend her soul to God's eternal care, we are reminded of the profound impact she made on those around her. As we can see, a lot of people are here that shows her kindness and love. So welcome you all this funeral mass and prayers. In this midst of our sorrow, we take comfort in knowing that she now rests in the loving embrace of her Creator. Her earthly journey complete and her spirit free from pain. Let us draw strength from the memories we shared with her, and may her legacy of kindness, compassion, and unwavering devotion inspire us to live our lives with greater love and purpose. As we entrust Anne Marie into God's merciful hands, let us find solace in the hope of the resurrection and the promise of eternal life in the presence of our Heavenly Father. Lord, you are slow to anger and rich in mercy. Lord, have mercy. You forgive our sins and heal our wounds. Christ, have mercy. You stand by us in good times and in bad. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life, so as to open up an eternity into the eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant Anne Marie to be inscribed the book of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. Now I invite Andrew and Rachel for the first and second readings.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. No torment shall ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like a disaster. They're leaving us like annihilation. But they are at peace. If they experienced punishment as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affection. Great will their blessings be. God has put them to test and proved them to be worthy with them. He has tested them like gold in a furnace and accepted them as a holocaust. When the time comes for his visitation, they will shine out. As sparks run through the stubble, so will they. They shall judge nations, rule over peoples, and the Lord will be their king forever. They who trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love, for grace and mercy await those he has chosen.
Second reading, a reading from St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We want you to be quite certain, brothers, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will all be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. We can tell you this from the Lord's own teachings, that any of us who are still alive will be taken up in the clouds, together with them, to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you should comfort one another. The word of the Lord.
Please stand for the gospel. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me will never die. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Martha said to Jesus, "If you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatever you ask of God, he will grant you." "Your brother," said Jesus to her, "will rise again." Martha said, "I know that he will rise again at the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," she said. "I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who was to come into this world." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. So, dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, the American composer Walter Murphy's album, The Phantom of the Opera, contains a beautiful piece of music called "The Music Will Not End." Its lyrics are amazing and beautiful. It reminds me of some people around us. It goes like this: "Why do I still hear that song? Show's over, everybody's gone. All the silence fills the empty hall, and there is no one here at all. Still the music will not end. Why is it still hear that song? Somewhere so deep in my soul, something so sweet and taken hold. A song so profound and so serene, like an echo in a dream, and the music will not end." It will be our feeling too when we leave a concert hall or an opera theater. The singer's face and her angelic voice will remain with us forever. How much more true this when it is somebody who fills our whole life with the rhythm of life and love. It is impossible to describe the feeling that comes over one at such a time. But the reality is that after the concert, the singer has said to goodbye and leave the theater. Singer can remain at the same stage forever. I'm quite sure this congregation sitting in front of me will have the same feeling as Anne-Marie. Say goodbye to each and every one of us after filling our life with the rhythm of love, rhythm of care, rhythm of compassion and kindness. And Mary had 7 children: Gerard, Thomas, Joan, Dolores, and Man Mary, Joseph, and late Jackie, and 16 grandchildren, 11 great grandchildren, and more than 1,000 friends who she loved dearly. She was born in Belfast, 1942. The family moved to Antrim in 1975. She played the role of a wife, mom, granny, and compassionate neighbor in its perfect manner. She was no stranger to our St. Comgall's Church, faithful to daily mass, as a reader spreading God's word to all. She sang in the choir, singing God's praises. After morning mass, she always led the hymn, and the congregation followed her. And Mary has also led the rosary at the daily mass, praying through the streaming to all who could not attend. She was one of the founder members of the parish play group, for her love of all children was immense. She was also a member of the Legion of Mary, devoted prayer to Mary, and an instrument of the Holy Spirit. And Anne Marie was no stranger to God or this church. Really, our parish community missed her presence. She was very proud of her children, who fulfilled her dream of getting higher education and became talented in their own areas of life. She always motivated them with the simple thoughts and encouraged them to reach at the star. She inspired them to the best always in their life, and be honest about it. She was a matriarch in the family and was treated like a queen. She was wholly dedicated to her family, and she was dearly loved. And this family will be sadly missed. The church and the faith played a big role in her life. In the midst of all her family commitments, she dedicated her time and energy for her church. She had a great devotion to the Holy Eucharist and attended benediction. And Anne Marie loved and respected her priest and was a gentle lady, always saying some positive thinking in the morning. I had the privilege to hear the meritorious stories about her traveling and spiritual experience, especially in Maggiore. And morning wishes in Italian or Spanish, Buona giornata, Dio di benedicta. That means God bless you and have a nice day. And Anne could always be described as a kind and generous woman who always enjoyed the company of others, having a bit of laugh. She had a great sense of humor and a strong character. Everybody liked her and spoke good about her. So dear friends, the shortest verse found in the entire Bible is John chapter 11, verse 35. That is, Jesus wept. That happened the time of the rising of Lazarus. Lazarus was very close to Jesus. His family was close to his heart. And Jesus wept as a broken. Today, he must be weeping again, for he looks down and sees the loss of Anne Marie. Even I feel one with the family, feel the loss of someone important. She was a lady of good at heart, just and kind, having led an exemplary life to every Catholic. He relays and smiling, telling everyone that she is coming home, going to what she dreamed of, that's none other than Jesus Christ. So as we pray for Anne Marie during this Mass, it's a good remember that the Mass is the greatest prayer for the dead. In the reading we heard, those who live, the love they will not die. The Lord will destroy the death forever. St. Paul underlines the same truth by saying that those who live, the love will rise again. Our loved ones have gone before us to see worship, to love and to intercede for us. When we reach that farther shore, we will meet them again. Meanwhile, we see them off going with us, for us we are allowed. We bid them farewell with our prayers. They have gone to better things. So we have to believe in the words of Jesus in today's gospel. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and am the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. As Christians, we have to put our trust in Jesus and put Anne Marie in the hands of Jesus. May the Lord forgive her any sins which she may have committed in her life, and may he welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. We trust in God and now live and marry in God's hands. Let us pray together. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. May her soul and the souls of the faithful rest in peace. Let us stand for the prayer of faithful. I invite Adam and David to say the prayer of faithful. God Almighty Father, raise Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. Response, Lord, graciously hear us.
For Nana, who in baptism she was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the family of our Nana, that we may be consoled in grief, in our grief by the Lord who wept, and the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For Nana's friends whose lives she enriched so deeply and who are gathered here today in remembrance of her life, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That God may welcome into his glory those of our family and friends who have departed this life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That all of us who are grieving the loss of Nana may be consoled and strengthened at this time. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voice of your people, whose lips were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. Those who are in offertory, please bring the offertory in the backside and come forward. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Let us pray. Be near, O Lord, we pray to your servant Anne Marie, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Amen. Lift up your hearts. Amen. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Amen. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for you are faithful, O Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with horns and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered in one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Anne Marie, whom you are called from this world to yourself. Grant that she was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, may the receiving of your body and behold the Lamb of God. Behold him takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. invite Joseph to say a few words.
Thanks to one and all for coming along today. Cead mila fáilte to you all. I'll just say a few words on behalf of the family, so bear with me, please. So where do you even begin with this wonderful person? With 7 children, a dog, a couple of goldfish and a tortoise, not to mention the piano in the kitchen. The Campbell McDonald household was a pretty lively place. And that's exactly how Anne-Marie loved it. Mum loved it. Friday night was chaos. The coal man was looking paid. The milkman was looking paid. The bread man, the man from the Prudential. Friends, family, neighbours, the door never stopped. And as I say, Mum loved it. She loved having children about. So much so that when the grandchildren went to school, and she didn't have any more children to take them to mass. She actually went through a wee phase of wheeling a lifelike doll around with her. His name is Jonathan, by the way. Some of you have probably met him. She thought this was hilarious. People stopped her to look at the baby. They got the fright of their lives, you know, when it wasn't moving. She was very, very talented. She wrote stories and poems and loved reciting these to people, quite often strangers who were a fresh set of ears. One time the Mormons came to the door and they actually couldn't wait to get away. Couldn't get a word in edgeways. She regaled with her compositions. She loved it. She loved music, especially the bass, and was often heard saying, "Turn it up. Turn that up. Turn that up, please." Listen to the bass. And there's even a Facebook evidence of the form of a video of her in her grandson Adam's car, raving with an umbrella in her hand. So that says it all, really. Regulars to St. Comgall's will know that she would always start a wee hymn at Mass in the hope that others would follow. And they always did. She played piano, and all the grandchildren love sitting at her keyboard, and there's not one of us who can't play chopsticks. God help the family when she discovered this new thing called Alexa. You know, in her house, and get her to play "I Want to Break Free" on repeat, repeat, repeat. So we all know it off by heart. Because she absolutely loved Queen, but mostly Freddie Mercury. Freddie could do no wrong. Although, Status Quo came in a close second with "Whatever You Want." We all know that one. She knew a couple of wee chords on the guitar, and every night before her prayers, she would play the tune, theme tune, to Match of the Day. I'll not sing it for you, okay? So, she would knit and crochet mountains and mountains of things for babies in Africa, Ukraine, or any hot country, really, that might need itself any woolen garments, things like that. Poor children were sweltered. Oh, and scarves, whether you wanted one or not. Even though she loved going for lunch with her family every Wednesday and to see her grandchildren, she was always chomping at the bit to get home in time for lingo. She loved crosswords and puzzles and had lots of love for words. A real logophile, and she would have loved that word. Cheese scones, any of you know my mum? She loved her cheese scones, or precisely M&S cheese scones. Yep, it was a wee obsession with these savoury treats. There are quite a few people here who somehow found themselves coerced into driving her up to M&S at the airport to clear the shelves of the cheese scone supply. But she always left one or two on the shelf for the next cheese scone fanatic. The highlight of her year was her annual pilgrimage to Medjugorje with her sister Colette. She did actually believe that she could speak the language, that she only knew one wee phrase, and she just repeated it for everything with firm commitment and fairness, and that was dobry otro. She added over the years a little bit to that, and it was dobry otro, kakuste, I say a prayer for you today. She was bonkers. And she loved it when people called her bonkers. The family used to say, "Mum, have a wee glass of cava and calm down." She said, no, alcohol makes me too quiet. She was a great believer in her guardian angel, and we take great comfort that he was with her in the end. And yes, she was convinced he was a he. She was a beautiful soul and the most lovely, kind, funniest, creative, loving, caring mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, sister, auntie, mother-in-law, and friend, and her light shone so brightly. The world would be much dimmer without her. May your light shine on in heaven, Mum. Love you. God bless you all.
Stand for the final prayers. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Anne Marie, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her, may it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Response: receive her soul and present her to God's Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul and present her to the God's Most High. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Receive her soul and present her to the Most High. In your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Anne Marie, the sure and the certain hope, that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us to remain to comfort one another with assurance of faith until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and with our sister forever. Once again, the family would like to thank everyone for attending this Mass. There is a short light refreshment after the funeral in Rococo restaurant that is near to our church. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest. I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever lives and believes in me shall never die.